Welcome guys, here's our second video in our duel series. Mario here, aka Hijinx. We've got Dale once again, and we have Gregory, aka Mr. Gregory.
Yep.
And Dale, you're playing?
I am playing Alice's World. This is very similar to the list that top, I think it came second at the most recent ARG or AGP and Dallas.
Okay. And Greg?
I'm just playing Kane Aggro, kind of based around the normal red list you're going to see. Just kind of want to try Kane because it seems pretty fun. It's kind of meta.
Alrighty. You guys haven't decided on who's going first or anything yet, right?
Nope.
Alright, let's get that die rolling.
I got a 5-8. I'll be in the play.
Alright.
Alright. So I'm going to be using these dice for reflect.
Okay.
Alright, so I'm on the play, so I'll be making mulligan decisions first. So with this hand, or well, with this deck in general, we are looking to have a Regalia in our opening hand. We do run four Ruler's Memorias, so we really want to have that turn one Regalia, so we're going to mulligan hard for it. We're going to ship this, which just is not really good in this matchup in general, and this is kind of a bit slow. We want these two, and this is a bit questionable, so we're going to ship this as well, just so that way we can find what we're looking for in our opening hand. So I'm going to ship three, and we're going to cry because we did not get there.
So the one we have, and knowing that in general these are really good cards, this is really the kind of thing we want, like turn one, especially if we get a second one. These we all want. These are really good, but especially only against like decks that are red and black because flames. So there they go. Not quite the dream, but close.
All right, you ready?
Yep.
So before we do anything, we have to cycle. We do run eight Regalia in the deck, and we didn't find one yet again. So I'm gonna ship one of these. We have two of these, although they are really good in this matchup. They're just not what we want right now, especially since we don't have basic stones that produce that color. Other than Memoria. We'll call a stone. We'll be surprised that we got there, I'm not gonna lie. Again, since we're digging, I'm gonna go for Cheshire Cat. One, two. I really don't have words for this. I don't know. I'm gonna put this back, we have one of these. So I'll pass the turn.
All right, draw. Decent maybe later on, we'll see. So just toss it out, fold this back because obviously there's blue on the board, not a good thing to see, and pass it back.
All right, so we'll start with a draw. And although he has one red open, I feel we have to go for this because we need to be able to see, we need to see Regalia. So we're gonna play Morgiana, and we're gonna try to cycle.
Big shot, and response, thunder.
Yep, you got it. I will take the cycle. This is just not good right now, so, you know what, actually, we are not gonna ship that. We're going to put this back on the bottom. We already have two of his effect in hand, so we don't need another one. At least this might have application later. We'll call a stone. And there's the Ruler's Memoria. We'll say go.
All right, so draw. It doesn't really smell spectacular here.
Really should verify that I have eight Regalia in here.
Might help, but hey. So, just... not seeing that much we really need to fear at this point. We can need to take a slightly concerted play here just to be safe. I'll call a second stone.
Yep.
And I get a little red. I choose red.
Big shock. Big shock.
Yeah, I know. And pass back to you. Against a combo type deck like this, you can't really just give them that one chance they need to go off. Even if it means going a turn slower.
So he definitely has more thunder-like removal, which really puts us like, we really want to throw this out there, but I don't think we can, because we currently only have the one. So what we'll do is we'll start with the cycle. This might come in handy for finding stuff, so we're gonna ship this. We have more of those in the deck. Let's see what stone we get. Deep wood. Okay, so knowing that that's our stone, we can shape our plays. I'm going to cast a Robe of the Fire Rat.
Sure.
It really helps. We do run three of these main board. And it's just a really helpful stone, or not stone, card to have. Play an Elvish Priest. Go ahead.
Alright, so nothing we really need to care about there at this point.
Elvish Priest is the best type of priest.
And I'm not a spectacular either, so recover. And da-da-da. Flip.
Yep.
Toss down a lathe. And at this point, we're in a pretty good position, so swing for seven.
Swinging for seven. We're at 40, which is a relatively safe life total. We do have a rogue out, so if he tries to come in with things later on in the turn, we're probably going to wind up taking nine if we don't block. So I'm fine with keeping the cat on the board here and proposing no blocks.
All right, you take seven then.
No. Okay, yeah. Boop.
And pass. The big thing like to not use Lave there is okay. It makes just using his ability a lot more potent.
Mm-hmm. So he still has the one red. So 90 times out of 10, he has Thunder. Nine times. Okay, we'll start with a Cheshire Cat. It's going to give us more blockers. We finally find one of these. Unfortunately, it's not the one that we want. We're going to put one of these back. Play Mary Bell. Call a stone. I think we will play a Speaker of Creation.
Yep.
Trigger. I really, really hate this current. So, our options here are to take one of these three. I think it is going to be this. I'll take another robe.
Fair enough.
We'll have combo is not what we're looking to do right now. So stalling for time is our best plan, our best approach. And play another robe.
Sounds good.
And I will cycle. We really don't need this. I'll put it at the bottom. And cycle.
Alright, so at this point we have him on the defense, we have Kane, and we have Lave. We are in pretty dang good position to remove everything we care about, so we draw first. Then we will activate Lave.
Mm-hmm.
Little reminder die. Then we will pop your priest for 400.
Rip.
Then recover. And beginning of main, we got a stone. At this point, nothing is really spectacular over here. Especially with two robes staring us in the face.
So this is when I really regret that last minute decision to take Rama the Pure Spirits out of the main board.
Womp womp. I will just go to combat. Swing at you for nine.
I'm gonna propose a block.
Sure. Cat trumps. Kinda expected. You can only get so many cats though. And think just to use the will while we have it, toss down an egg.
Mm-hmm.
And his gift.
Takashan.
Anytime. And back to you.
No, I draw first.
Well done.
Alright. So I think still now he's a mono red, so like probably has split somewhere in the deck. Not sure if they're gonna be main or side, but we're gonna try to get somewhere this turn. Gonna try to make some plays. Morgiana.
Yes.
So from there you're gonna cast a familiar of Holy Wind.
I am going to response, activate Lave, lots of damage.
Yep.
And open fire on Morgiana.
I will respond with a cycle.
I'll respond with open fire on Morgiana.
Sure. So we managed to get two cycle. Two activations out of his Morgiana, out of his cane there. Hopefully we'll be able to find another Morgiana, but that's being pretty, this is draw from familiar, being pretty hopeful. Aiden Brawley.
Sure. You've managed to eat two of his four Morgianas maximum, because a combo dex is a pretty dang good position to be. We can attrition a combo deck, especially as an aggro type thing like this, it's not a bad place to be.
I will produce a green with Aiden Brawley. I will play Familiar of Holy Wind.
Okay, that's not Morgiana.
Morgiana.
Okay.
Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to get much value out of her before she gets eaten away. I'm going to call a stone.
Sure.
We are going to use the orb to remove two counters and draw a card.
Yep.
We're going to look at these. I think we're going to take this because we can do things with that. Is that correct? Yes. You can just get more value. We are going to cast a cat.
Sure.
2, 3. Out of these three, I like this most because it's going to gain us value. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to take this and set it up for next turn as my draw. Play Change the World. The world will be changed. Go ahead.
Okay, so two cards in hand, right?
I have two cards in hand, yes, this is correct.
Two cards, that many things down. We cannot let him actually get Alice's World off the ground next turn, so we're gonna have like clear a lot of stuff. Let's draw. And nothing for your recovery. Beginning of main, get a stone. Oop.
I really like that that's how they made Kane work. I really wish that they would do something similar to that with other rulers.
Be pretty cool, yeah. Not much of this is really useful right now, so I think we just activate Lave. Boop. And in the choice first. We will attack you for 9.
For 9? So barring double split, which would be absolutely just atrocious, I don't think we're going to die if we take this damage. I don't want to give up any of my resonators right now. I need as many as I can, so I'm going to go no blocks.
Okay, 1 second here. Time for math.
Time for math?
Mathematics, sir.
Mephistopheles.
That's entirely what I said, sure. Now at this point, don't think, let's see. Add to that, we put up to 11 off that. Just short.
Are you trying to RTK me?
I'm thinking about how close. If I wasn't silly, I think I could have actually done it. Yeah, well. So in this case, we will banish egg to our sword.
Sure.
We have tutor. I don't think we have anything that's really relevant right now. Closest thing is probably Gwyn.
Sure.
Not a bad card.
General value. Yeah. Having double move is like really good. Yeah.
So yeah.
You're going to shoot 6 damage at things.
Well, first you take 11.
Yeah.
That's how damage works.
22.
Then, yeah, let's open some fire. Pew.
1.
Pew.
2.
Pew, pew, pew. I actually want to go with that.
You killing speaker?
I think I need to. It's just so annoying that I'm this close. And I will indeed pew speaker.
Sure.
Then, because we can't really kill anything else, let's just toss down Gwyn, hope to get some value before next turn.
Sure.
Pass.
Before recovery. I will add a counter. Still before recovery, I will prevent all the damage Guinevere will take this turn.
Because that's going to be entirely relevant, but okay.
Draw a card. Hey, you never know. Cover.
So then you meant at the start of your draw phase, then?
Yes, so before I drew that was when I did all that.
Okay. Just to clarify for people so they're not confused.
Yeah. Alright, so how much mana do we have? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, you may. Okay. There's 3 more Gyanas in there if that's what you're counting. We have currently access to 5 mana. We have 2 dorks out. So they're going to reduce our rolls by 2. So we're looking to say 6. We do have enough mana to do it this turn. So we're going to. Each of these will cast at net neutral for mana. Sprite. We'll call a stone. We are going to cycle.
Yep.
Put that on the bottom. He's currently tapped out. I'm going to go for Analysis World here.
Sure. Can't do much about that.
We're going to add 2 counters to Reflect.
Yep.
And we're going to go into our next turn.
All right.
Let's draw. We will recover. Okay. So we will start with a cycle. This is just not. Cheshire Cat.
Sounds good.
So we really just want to dig. So we're going to put this one on the bottom. So we're really diluting our number of casts here.
Cheshire Cat?
Yeah. Oh, bottom. Right, that's correct. No, that was, yeah, that was Cheshire Cat.
Yeah,
sorry.
Cheshire Cat.
Thank you. Sorry.
No problem.
Good catch. We're going to play another Cheshire Cat.
Sounds good. You played no more before
this
that.
This is happy. This is happy days. Morgiana.
Yep.
Move 2 counters. This should be at 6. I apologize. Mm-hmm. Draw a card.
And you pay a green, do you not?
Yeah, I paid with Elfish Priest.
Oh, that's what you paid with? Sorry, yep. My bad. Didn't see it.
Alright, all of these are really good cards here. But we're going to take this, because we don't have one of these yet. So it'll help reduce our cost. We'll play Familiar.
Sure.
So just for those of you at home, he activated Morgiana's.
Yeah, this is all Morgiana triggers. For those who are not familiar with how Morgiana works.
Replacement effects.
Yeah.
Whenever you would draw a card, it's not your first draw for the turn. Instead, you look at the top 3, 1 to the hand, and then proceed with like putting one on the bottom or whatever.
5.
No, the other 2 you look at do go on
call
the
bottom. Call a stone. 1, 2, and play a Speaker of Creation.
Okay.
That's going to let us tutor another copy of Alice's World. Now we have six unique resonators here. Elf, human, fairy, 12 Apostle Cthulhu, ancient and familiar cat. I'm very glad that that's a cat.
I love how they do the typing for this game. Totally yeah. Not silly.
We pay two, and we're going to cast another Alice's World, so we're going to take another turn.
I'm entirely shocked.
I will add a counter. I will go to my next turn. Draw first. That's how it works.
You're not on the ball with that one this time for some reason.
So we're gonna be fast and loose. We're gonna what's it called? Cycle. There is one card in particular that I just really want to find. That can't tap for mana. Cheshire Cat.
Yep.
Three. We're gonna take one of these. Just in case we can't kill him this turn.
And again, for you folks at home, because Cheshire draws two, the replacement effect happens for both draws.
I'm actually surprised nobody's tried playing Lay the Foundation with this deck, honestly. We don't need this. We're gonna put this back on top. We're gonna do... So this came in this turn. We're gonna play Sprint.
Let's do quick mathematics. 18. Yeah, we cannot block enough, so that's game one.
Alright. Alright.
Thought things out a bit more there. We could have probably got away with it, but
yeah, you held on.
Ugh. The double robe was
annoying.
Absolutely, just did work for us there.
In this case,
this that's is pretty crazy. All right, so we're gonna get sideboarded up here, and we'll be right back when we're ready to go with game two. All right, welcome back, guys. We're here with sideboards now, and since Greg lost the first game, he's gonna explain his sideboard first. Take it away, Greg.
All right, so it's pretty straightforward. Maribel's we only actually have in the main in case of Flame Out our World, and then there's a damage our ruler. So they're coming out. Susan Owo. We don't really see any Gwyvers in the main. We're kind of trying to keep them on the back foot, so we won't even like have a chance to play them. So not too useful. Lilldra's kind of like just a mid-game card that I don't think is going to be like two to backbreaking here, so out. Ame, again, seeing two robes there in the main, that's... Ame doesn't quite do it.
Yeah.
Bringing in, though, we have two Demon Flames, another like one cost removal spell, keep them up, morgues, there are big things if we need to. Flame King Shout, clears off his little dudes, hopefully lets us win. Rapid Decay, another one drop removal spell, not instant, but hey, it kills almost anything that we really care about on his side. And Dual Truth, pretty much the same thing as Rapid Decay, instant. We do need a Resonator or a J-Ruler, but still does the work whenever it needs to. And let's talk to Dale now.
Okay, so for cards that we're taking out, we're going to take out two Gwyver. He is a red deck, so actually we're assuming that they're going to be coming in on more copies of Susan Owo. So we're going to take out Gwyvers just because they almost become a liability in this kind of deck. We're taking out a Horn of Sacred Beasts and a Maribel as Regalia, which will be supplemented by the two Death Sites that we're bringing in for our count. We didn't see anything that we need to Maribel. And to be completely honest, the list was running the Maribel in the main, but I'm not quite sure why, other than just Regalia Destruction. It does hit Schrodinger, if that's really a thing. And we're taking out the Horn. We just don't really need the deck cycling in this matchup. It's not going to, hopefully not going to go long. It's going to be either he wins before this is required or I win before it's required. Barrier is not going to do much. It's not going to affect much in this game. And we're going to cut one Elvish Priest because we needed to cut a sixth card. And he has a lot of spot removal for our small dorks. So it just is a weaker card, and it was probably one of the least impactful cards for us to cut. We're also going to be switching from Reflect to Blazer because he's on a J-Ruler-centric strategy, in a sense, with Kane kind of acting as a way of removal. And Threat, we're going to switch to Blazer. Hopefully that'll just keep him from flipping. We're going to bring in 2-Realm. 2-Realm almost kind of feels like a bit overkill in this deck. It is protection against stuff like his spot removal. It helps, again, if Kane flips, we can't get shot by Kane. 2-Hera. We saw a couple of Regalia, specifically Laviton, so there might be bows in the main or bows in the deck somewhere that we are bringing these in to see to hit against. And Deathscythe, just as a way to stop Laviton again and Kane. It also works with Hera if we need to draw a card in a pinch and we have a Deathscythe out, we can just Hera while we're on Deathscythe and then bring it back by exiling 3 cards from our graveyard. So that is my sideboard strategy in this matchup.
All right. So Greg, you're going to be on the play?
Yep.
Sounds good. Take it away.
Your card mostly normal stone deck, if you want.
You're 9 fire stones and 1 little red.
That's what you think.
No, yeah, you could be sideboarding stones.
Totes.
Cut my deck.
That's good.
Okay.
Have you seen anybody do that yet? Sideboarding stones?
Yes. I think I saw somebody sideboard a Mooch Dart.
I've heard similar things.
Yeah, that's fair.
So looking at this, good cards. Pretty good if we get the right kind of card in the draw. I don't think we're going to have the time to cast that in this. Not really where I want to be with this matchup, so toss those. And okay.
Alright, so here this card was an absolute house last game, so we're gonna be keeping this. Obvious reasons why we're keeping this one. And as well for this, these are just 2 key cards for the deck, as well as just a solid card. So we're gonna keep those 3. These are 2 late game cards. So we're going to ship these, we're going to draw 2. Could have been worse, could have been better, but...
All good?
Yep.
Alright, so stone, yep. I choose fire, pass.
So we'll draw. Alright. I just realized a very interesting thing with this deck and the way I sideboarded.
Well.
Do change.
That's kind of awkward.
Oh shit.
We're gonna call a stone.
There's gonna be 1 magical clown.
Yeah.
Well, you can still draw.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Just saying, magic clown.
Yeah. I'm gonna take 2.
Yeah.
For familiar.
Yeah.
Alright. Go ahead.
So we don't really care about that, so I'm gonna get pass. Draw. Alright.
Like, change the world.
Call.
Is still decent with Blazer. Like, it's not the end of the world. We definitely still need Regalia draw before recovery at 2.
Yep.
So keeping it in the deck is not the end of the world. Call a stone. I will take 2. I will play a Morgiana. Morgiana.
Smooth. Smoke.
Now, is it really Morgiana? Because I find it more comfortable to say Morgiana.
I'm not sure.
We'll look that up at some point. Continue.
I'm pretty sure like most people are going to call it Morgiana because of League of Legends. I'm pretty sure that's a character in that.
Yes.
I'm going to play Deathscythe.
Sure.
And I am going to ship the turn your way, Greg.
I'm going to snap that thing off.
To respond by paying a green and tapping an orb to remove 2 counters and draw a card.
Sure.
So, placement effect will happen. So we already have one of these, so we don't need that. Probably just gonna take this because we don't need this either at this point. So Morgiana will bite the dust
and draw. This isn't the worst thing, but with what's looming, we can't really, unfortunately.
I'm gonna bolt my cat. You wanna thunder my cat?
No, that's fine. Recover. Sure. Then we'll call.
Oh, there's no more counters on him.
We can't really even do that at this point, so we just need to pass.
And
can't let these go down.
End of turn, whatever.
Yeah.
Alright. Draw. Recover. Call a stone. Alright, so I think what we're going to be doing here is we're going to go for some of our strategy that we did last turn in casting Morgiana.
Yep.
Now he has mana available, so we're going to cast an Elvish Priest.
Sure.
We're going to shift the turn your way.
Okay, and big shocker. Demon Flame or Morgue?
I will respond. I'll take two. I assume this is during my end step?
Yep.
Or whatever it is in this game?
Yeah.
I will attempt to draw a card by... first I have to add a counter.
Yes.
And then attempt to remove two counters to draw a card.
Sure.
So... I think that this is just strictly the best out of these. He doesn't have anything for this to be really worth it. And we want to dig deeper into our deck, so we're going to take that. And Morgiana will die.
The reason we don't get away with like one or two of them is it doesn't really like break our backs, especially since we have two of the Morgues already gone.
Mm-hmm.
We really want to just hold this up, honestly. So we go to draw.
Woo!
Alright, and now we're getting some cards, at least.
No. Do you not have cards before?
No. No. I have no cards here. What are cards? No. And
six cards is not enough?
Nah. Firestone, Big Shock, and can't quite go to that yet. So let's just do two, play a Lance.
Sure.
Combat Zone.
Is that similar to the Danger Zone?
Combat Zone.
Is that similar to the Danger Zone?
For six.
I'm going to block.
Okay.
Good?
Yep. In this case... Cards in hand?
I have four.
Four cards.
Are you gonna him to Torak me?
Kinda just wait on this.
What is it in this game? Spiral of Despair?
It's go. That's what it is.
Draw. Alright, that's a nice card to draw. Recover. Call of Stone.
Yeah.
There's a painless color, or source of red. That's nice. I'm gonna play a Change the World. We really don't like the current world we're in, so we're just gonna keep changing it. Produce a blue for Cheshire Cat.
Yep.
We're gonna take this. Just to, I don't know, do things. Seems like the best card here.
Sorry, why did cards go on the bottom?
That was from Cheshire Cat. So we're doing that. Cheshire, that was two. So I picked one. Two cards go on the bottom.
No, it goes on the bottom. No.
Oh!
You have no morgue.
You have no morgue, man.
Whoops!
Right.
Whoa!
Okay. Disqualified.
Actually, though, that's terrible. Where is it? It's here.
This is so spectacular.
These are the three cards.
The audience will know if you're lying.
Yeah, I don't remember what order they were drawn in, though. Pick one and put one on top. Okay. So these are the two that I'm going to be drawing from the Cheshire Cat. I know how to play this game. I thought I had Morgiana.
I've been making sure that doesn't happen.
I guess that Elvish Priest does look kind of feminine, but...
Shh. Alright, now that we've actually done that properly, and I'm terribly sorry. That's really awkward.
Skill on this guy.
Very skilled. Speaker creation.
Yes. Speaker is fine.
Tutor.
Yeah.
Four. Now we're... probably gonna take this.
I got a feeling.
And take a realm.
That's a shocker.
No, that's a realm.
I know.
And then we are going to... cast a robe.
Cast a robe? What?
So I feel pretty comfortable about the situation we're in right now, so I am going to ship the turn away.
In this case, I really kind of just want to toss this out, but let's not. Let's be a bit more defensive here. So let's go draw.
Defensive against Alice's world?
Yes. If I let you combo off, you win. If I don't let you combo off, you don't win. That's how combos work.
No, you could be like me when I played Storm and just whiff like 90% of the time.
I will, before recovery, buff my Lancelot.
You got it.
Okay. Then I'll recover.
Yep.
In this case, I will just grab me a stone. We'll go for that, that, that. Looking to sequence ended at this to get a good smack in. So let's go to an attack.
Sure.
I will attack towards you with Lancelot. Trigger targeting her.
So we really don't know what could have that he wants to follow it up by. If we decline to if we robe it here and he has something more threatening, like an Ame on another Lancelot, we could be in a world of hurt. Right now we're looking to take no damage if we do it right. I'm going to let the trigger resolve. And then I will block.
Sir. Oh. The trigger doesn't actually do anything.
Oh.
It's an 8-8. Do you block? Yep.
Way to make me look like a fool on camera once again.
I try.
That's twice already in this game.
Yeah. Trigger? Sir, please clean up your play.
Extremely sloppy.
I noticed.
It's okay. I probably would have done the same thing.
I know. So, in this case, Incarnate Cthulhu. Combat zone. Attack your priest.
Attacking priest. Alright, so he's 5 cards in hand?
Yep.
Probably has like 2 removal spells in hand. So, what do I value more? I'm going to value the speaker less than Elvish Priest here, just because Elvish Priest produced mana. So I'm going to block.
Okay. So, 3, Cthulhu.
Literally hard casting Cthulhu.
Yes.
I am fine with this.
Good. Literally attacking your Elvish Priest.
I'm going to robe it.
Okay. So,
another Cthulhu?
Cthulhu.
All right.
Priest dies.
Rip.
Pass.
In pepperonis. add 3 counters.
Pass.
Cover. Nope, draw.
You know you just made me hungry for pizza now, right?
Good thing there's a pizza store next door.
Pizza store or pizzeria?
Pizza store, pizzeria, pizza shop. It's pizza.
They just sell pizza a bit different.
Isn't this like an important distinction for you?
A what?
An important distinction?
Hey man, just because I'm Italian, okay? Like, and I got the name Mario, doesn't mean shit.
He's not a plumber. You think he's a plumber?
It's a me, Mario!
Okay, so we really just don't. So I'm gonna put. I draw both of these. And. Really. Don't need this. So just
what? You grow up with that name, you gotta learn how to do that shit.
Cards in hand?
Can't 3. Just, like, not
3 cards in hand.
Oh my god, Luigi, what are we gonna do?
We're gonna play a Realm of the Pure Spirits and see how he reacts to that.
Mm-hmm. Well, yes, that happens. Well done.
All right.
Not much can be done.
So, I will then remove two counters and draw a card.
Sure.
We will then cast an Elvish Priest and Seiko.
All right. Draw a card. Whoop. Pretty good to see right now, especially what we have. So
two more Morgianas in the deck.
Before recovery, let's just pop a plus two on this dude.
Sure.
That will recover. Don't need to do that. Don't need to do that. Let's call
it down. Should have played this instead of drawing the card and the priest, but.
So, combat zone.
Yep.
I will swing at you for seven.
Four cards in hand?
Yes. Apparently our opponent cannot count. Otherwise you know we are 3+1.
I'll block.
Okay. And then I'm going to attack you with Psychothuga.
I'll take five.
Okay. Then let's just toss it down to Guinevere. And at this point we kind of just want to hold these up and pass.
Before the end of your turn, or whenever, I will add a counter.
Yep.
Green, move two, draw a card.
I will. You draw a card, but I'm going to like Thunder your elf because you're now tapped.
That's fine. That was a risk we had to take to get the card, and the card that we got was pretty decent. So, draw for turn. Recover. What do we have to work with? A lot of awkwardness, really. We will call a stone.
That sure is a stone.
I always wondered, so like, do the rulers just instinctively know the numbers for the stones? Or like, do they have to look them up in a phone book?
I don't think you know how magical calling works.
Speaker.
Yep.
I don't.
I wonder what he's gonna get.
You know what we really needed there?
What?
A set of drums after you said that.
But
no.
That would have just made my day.
Get an Alice's World.
Somebody just came out of like left field with that.
Alice's World. That's actually interesting.
You should edit that in.
No, the people know that's an edit.
They'll do it in post.
It's not genuine.
Do it in post, mate. Producing a red, we're gonna find another rope.
Yeah. That explains why you got that.
Yeah.
Right now.
Going to add two counters.
Yep.
And then
okay, need to remove one.
Remove two counters, draw a card.
Gotcha.
One spark.
Sure.
Pass the turn.
Okay, so now we get to the point where our draws are incredibly just. They kind of decide the game. Let's see. Draw.
Split.
That's kind of a card.
Split.
This point, it feels a lot more worth it to just toss Gwyn out and just hope we get something really good off her. Draw.
Split.
Draw.
Split.
Okay, we have pretty good options here. So, toss a lave. Then, before recovery, we will buff this Cthulhu.
Sure.
and they'll recover.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't quite call yet. What we do is we go to combat zone.
Sure.
Seven.
I'm gonna rub it.
Okay. Five.
Cards in hand?
Four.
Four. I'm at 29.
Yep.
Yeah. So we can only have one more Cthuga. If he has Lancelot Ame, I will declare no blocks.
I will buff.
Sure, I'll take seven.
Okay. I'll take seven. Well, buff doesn't really matter right now, though. At this point, what do we actually want? I'm going to pay one and I'm going to toss down an egg.
Yep.
I'm going to play a lave.
Sure.
Just in case we kind of go for a wonky route, tap lave, then banish egg to lave.
Yep.
And let's see if we can pull out something we forgot. It'd be really good here. Can't do that, can't do that. Unfortunately, I think we kind of need this. Could be worse. Find Gwen.
Yep.
And at this point, to Lancelot.
Sure.
Combat.
Mm-hmm.
Swing.
I'm gonna rub it.
Okay. We expected not much else to be done there. I think we just, that wouldn't be worth it. Call stone.
Mm-hmm.
Boop. And use a stone to play Guinevere.
Sure.
Pass.
So it's gonna fall off. Sure, draw. All right, we're in business now.
We'll see about that.
We'll start by calling a stone, since mm-hmm. we're just never gonna flip laser gear. Like, literally never. We don't need the yellow for anything in particular. Morgiana.
Yep.
I will make the proposed shortcut.
Yep.
With that, to draw a card.
Yep.
So we're gonna take this, just the best out of those three, the only one that we need right now. We're gonna cast a Cheshire Cat.
Yep, it's getting kind of gross.
Good?
Yep.
Okay. So I think, really with our current situation, we're gonna take this. Second one. So we want to avoid tapping our Wind Sprite. This for a turn after might be good. So we're gonna take that and ship these two to the bottom. So we currently have a reduction of four. I need to put one back. It's easily going to be that card. I'm going to reduce by five.
It was spawns. I think I need to take a hope here. I'm going to win a Cthuga.
Sure.
Let's see. Do we get anything really live? Not really. Toss Thunder and proceed.
Okay. We're gonna play an Elvish Priest.
Sure.
An Elvish Priest.
Elvish.
I will take two, producing a blue.
Yep.
I'm gonna cast an Elvis's World.
Yep.
I think that's everything for a turn, so I'm gonna attempt to go to my next turn.
Yep.
Draw. Knew that was there, unfortunately. We're gonna call a stone. We're gonna utilize our proposed shortcut here.
Yeah.
To look at the top three. We're gonna take this to act as fodder for this. Because we need to keep drawing cards here. We're going to play a wind sprite.
Okay.
We are going to. This is gonna be dangerous. If he responds by thundering it, it's not the end of the world. We can still keep going. I'm going to float a yellow.
Yep, you sure have a yellow.
I will incarnate.
You do know that I can't respond to like mana to wheel abilities, right?
Oh.
Yeah.
Sure. Judge.
I try.
Full of professional playing this game. Draw.
Yep.
Going to produce blue. So that's really awkward. So maybe, yeah, two yellow, and we're gonna have a blue floating.
Yep.
We're going to incarnate again.
All right.
No, that goes to the graveyard this time. One, two, three. This is just really good right now. Like, absolutely needed. Just like the best thing to see. Hera.
Yep.
We need to target our death scythe here.
All right.
Because if we target that Laveton, he's just going to banish it in response.
Would not quite go well.
What's in our hand? He is at 40. What hasn't... what came in this turn? These two. So it's 12, 3, 4, so 16 plus 12, 24, 16 plus 24 is 40. We are going to cast Sprint of the Beast Lady.
Yeah, that sure is a sprint.
So we will go to combat. Attack for 18.
Yep, Xaxi's on 40. Yep, that's it.
I'll play.
The slowest draws.
I just want to see your hand for a second.
I just drew into that. One turn too late.
Oh. And that's how you successfully dodge splits.
By not having
your opponent draw them.
Pretty much. Three in the deck and not a single one early enough. Does he shout either?
Man, like I kept staring at that split and I'm like, man, if he doesn't do anything, it's game over.
Yeah,
you have one shot.
I expected I'd be dead if I didn't. If I let him untap.
But that's the power of freaking that card right there. Morgan. MVP of the damn game.
Yeah, actually, if I had to like make a list of top 10 cards in the game, I'd easily be putting Morgiana at the top.
That's not Morgiana.
This is Hera. I'm deboarding.
I love how, okay, there's four things in the game that are story type. Why is that not a fairy tale, you'd think?
Because typing is not a thing.
They're thoroughly just weird and fickle typing is so annoying in this
game. You gotta remember, this was also made before Jordan.
I know.
Yeah. Team.
I know, but still, it's just so weird the way they did typing for this. Familiar isn't a beast. That's not a fairy tale. Ugh. Cheshire Cat isn't a cat.
You know, I'm like, wait, what's that? I think Cheshire Cat came out after, too.
Because I think of the fact that they drew her as a non-cat.
No, never mind.
She's like, a lady with cat parts.
It's literally Cheshire Cat.
That's a dude. That's not a dude, dude.
That's a dude. That's
Cheshire not a dude. Cat. I do not care about what it is. There's literally the word cat in his name. It's not a cat. What is it?
So that's like saying Batman's not a bat.
Yes. That's a real life-ish setting where he's dressed up as a bat.
Not necessarily.
You know, okay. More importantly, you do know that the artist said that this was a guy.
I don't know that. I've never heard anything about that, so I have no clue.
The artist for both Cheshire Cat, and he also did the art for Medusa, both of whom are men. They are traps.
I want to see Medusa's art now. That's actually really interesting.
Do you have a copy of it, like, somewhere?
I literally traded all of them to you.
To me?
Yes.
No.
Who are you? Who are Medusa's? Someone Medusa's.
That's weird. Because, like, aren't Gorgons in general all female?
Yes, but that's so... Yeah, no. It was drawn as a guy. They're just traps.
It's weird. Anyways. Feelings on the match?
Yeah, closing thoughts, I guess. You want to go first?
Having three Cthulhus and nothing to incarnate in the opening hand is pretty rough. I just feel my deck would have performed a lot better if I just did not get really badly done on the draws. It didn't do badly overall. The way I tried to play, I think it was probably about correct. Like, I can't think of any like major misplays I made there. Tried to hold out things like destroy them. I couldn't really go for like the full out aggro because I know if I do let him go, he's going to just destroy me in one turn.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of where you need to play a bit conservatively, and if I do let him flip the Blazer, well, that might have been a positive thing earlier on, make him miss a stone drop, but even then. Good match overall.
Yep. I think that I definitely don't, in future, I don't want to be playing 2 Realm. The second Realm, I did wind up drawing it, and it was stuck in as a dead card in my hand. There are a lot of ways for you to filter your cards away in this deck, but... it just feels like the opportunity cost of running 2 Realm is just too, I guess, I don't know. You don't want to be doing it. You want something else in this slot. Maybe one of these main would even be, depending on your meta, would be a consideration. I definitely also, like, you're definitely inclined when you're switching into Blazer to cut your orbs. But I think there, it really showed that keeping orbs in is not the end of the world.
They're still decent, but it's the kind of thing where if you don't get multiples, it's really, really just kind of feels bad, I'd imagine.
Yeah, but I think this is, like, the only deck where you can really get away with keeping them in because you're not, you're filtering through your deck a lot quicker. With Morgiana, and other cards.
So like you said, it's not the end of the world. However, it is a different change of the
Please
world.
Please stop.
Yes.
I'm walking away.
Okay. Well,
I'm 2 for 2, so...
There you have it. Any comments, suggestions? What did you like about the video? What you didn't like about the video? Put it in the comments below. Hit the like button if you enjoyed it. Subscribe, because it does help us. And... till next time, see you guys later. Hey guys, just wanted to give a quick shout out to Black Knight Games for providing us with a recording location. They are located in Hamilton, Ontario, a great place for all your card game, board game, and miniature needs. Great staff and lots of room. If you're ever in the area, be sure to check them out for F&Ms and pre-releases, or heck, just stop on by to take a look around. This is Hijinks of TCG Hut, and I'll see you guys in the next video.